The golden rule of transplanting vegetable seedlings in the field is this: treat them like fresh eggs. That is, be very careful. Seedlings like these that have been hardened in direct sun will have a better chance of surviving when transplanted into the field. Just before transplanting, drench the hardened seedlings with diluted liquid manure. This will help stimulate root growth and avoid transplant shock. Old seedlings like these at 7 to 8 weeks are no good, so don't plant them. Keep a safe distance between the roots and the fertiliser. A high salt concentration around the roots will burn them. When removing seedlings from the container, handle them very gently. Transplanting can be done either manually or by machine. Air dries out seedling roots and can kill them quickly. So once a seedling is out of its container, it needs to be bedded into the soil straight away. And then water around the whole base to exclude air. Try not to let the water touch the leaves. If the soil is very dry, it can suck moisture from the plant cells to the soil, the reverse of what we want. The top of the cell needs to be at ground level and the cotyledons are just above. Seven to 10 days after transplanting, apply NPK fertiliser. By this stage, it's critical for the plant to have good root ball soil contact. So you've got the old cell from the nursery and the new roots which have established in the field. Beautiful. At this stage, mulching reduces water loss and controls weeds. So whether you're transplanting by hand or machine, if you get it right, this is what your crop should look like a month after transplanting.